go to church on Sunday, we have our purpose in everything we do. But what I am talking about this purpose is the purpose that will fulfill us temporarily. We do something we want, and after that, it fulfills us and nothing more. But today, I will be talking about a kind of life that is a purpose-driven. A purpose-driven in a dictionary means that there will be inside, or there will be an inner force, there will be a strong, that is something inside that motivates us to do such purpose. And the purpose that the Bible is telling us is the purpose that will fulfill our soul forever. And it can be happen if, first thing, number one, it can be happen if we will be laying our foundation in Christ, if we laid our foundation in Christ. According to Matthew chapter 7, verse 24 to 27, everyone is familiar with this parable. Matthew chapter 7, verses 24 to 27. Therefore, everyone who hears these words of mine and puts them into practice is like a wise man who built his house on the rock. The rain came down, the streams rose, and the winds blew and beat against that house. Yet it did not fall, because it had its foundation on the rock. But everyone who hears these words of mine and does not put them into practice is like a foolish man who built his house on sand. The rain came down, the streams rose, the winds blew and beat against that house, and it filled with a great crush. We know that the parable means an earthly story with a spiritual meaning. And this parable does not mean that we are building something, that we are using construction materials, but Jesus is telling us that we are building something for eternal. And there will be two builders here. First is the foolish, second is the wise. The foolish builders build his house on the sun, meaning, kabalo naman kita ngayon sa sun, hapos na kayo i-build a house. It is very easy, inexpensive, kaya it takes a very little time. And a wise builder naman, ang iyaya na foundation, dito yung i-build sa rock. Kagabalo naman kita ngayon sa rock, it takes a lot of effort para ma-build yung mga house sa rock. And also, expensive man siya. Siyempre, tapang ka sa mga gamiton na doon nga mapakinggong na lang yung mabalay. God is telling us, Christ is telling us, that whatever we want something in the future, whether a career, whether a family, whether job, something na gusto natin matapos sa ulihi, ang atong na foundation dapat sa kay Jesus Christ. In 1 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 4, please, 1 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 4. And drank the same spiritual drink, for they drank from the spiritual rock that accompanied them, and that rock was Christ. So if we will lay our foundation in Christ, if we will lay our foundation on the rock, we have our strong foundation. And whatever God wants us to do, the purpose that God wants us to fulfill, we will fulfill because our foundation is in Christ. We were created to be in a relationship with Jesus. Mungkin ang purpose ng ito, o nga gusto niya nga may kita relationship sa niya. And the kind of relationship that Jesus wants us to have is that a relationship that will last forever. Amo na gusto yung relationship. Relationship on earth, a relationship that will not last forever. Temporary relationship. But Christ wants us to have a lasting relationship. And we know that on earth, marriage, a happy marriage life. Then, start nila sa wedding. Yesterday, nag-attend ko sa wedding ni Arlene, sister nila ni Rinsel. Kanaming isang iya sa ilang wedding. Kanaming isang reception, sa program. Kag-happy sila sa iya na Swiss na husband, si Kenneth. So, makita natin na kung gusto natin relate na maayo ang future, dapat ma-start nila sa maayo na foundation. And, ano ba na gusto ng Ginoo? God wants us to be married in Christ. How? Hindi lang niya gusto ng ating relationship kay Christ, temporary lang. Gusto niya na ma-materialize. Gusto niya na makita kita ni Bidensya. So He wants us to be married in Christ through the church. In Ephesians chapter 5, verse 22 to 23. Basahin na ito. Ephesians chapter 5. This is the kind of foundation na gusto sa Ginoo na ang relationship natin mabuo. Ephesians 5:22-23. Sige nga. Wives, submit to your husband as to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ is the head of the church, His body, of which He is the Savior. Means to say that when we obey the gospel, we are already belong to the church, and therefore the church is the wife of Christ. And this is the beginning of a lasting relationship. So kung belong kita sa church, kag ang church kili, amo ang wife ni Christ, dapat may ara ang church kag si Christ, relationship na mag-last. So amo ini ang gusto sa Ginoo. Amo ni ang gusto sa Ginoo nga foundation. We were married in Christ through the church. And the relationship that God wants us is the relationship that will last forever. That even death will not separate. Ang marriage, there is a duta. After death, yeah, mano na, wala na. Wala. But if we will be married in Christ, we will be married to Him forever. And our relationship will last forever. So if we want that our life is driven with purpose, then first, we must lay our foundation in Christ. Second, if we have already that kind of relationship with Christ, then the second thing that we must do is we must live with Christ. In 1 John chapter 3, verse 2, this is the verse that we have been discussing in our Jesus Talk in Chicken Hotel last Thursday. Basahin ako. Dear friends, now we are children of God, and what we will be has not yet been made known. But we know that when He appears, we shall be like Him, for we know we shall see Him as He is. According to Apostle John, this is just the beginning. Salvation is just the beginning of our living in the kingdom of God. And the components of the kingdom are still on effect. So, what's going on? Although we are children of God because we obey the gospel, it will not stop there. Na mga kaanakan kita si Ginoo sa time na obey kita sa gospel. But, according to Corinthians, we must work out our salvation with fear and trembling. Dapat ato ni itrabaho na ato ng kaluwasan. Because remember, if we will fail by doing this kind of following Jesus Christ, then we will lose our salvation. In Philippians chapter 1 verse 6, according to Apostle Paul, in Philippians chapter 1 verse 6, being confident of this, that He who began a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Jesus Christ. So gusto ng Ginoo nga may nahutay kitagaling sa paglagad sa iyan. Nahutay kit. The components of the kingdom, kapalag na kita ang components of the kingdom, may arap sing king, may arap sing territory, may arap sing law, may arap sing citizens. So Christ is the king, the church is the territory, ang Bible mo ang law, and the Christians are the citizens. If we do not obey the law, then do you think we will be last until na makabot si Jesus Christ? We will be completed sa mission niya ginatag ni Jesus Christ after. So it is our responsibility to work out our salvation, because we have our hope that someday we will be like Him. The thing that we are doing today, according to our first point, na dapat kung ano ato ni Mohon Solong, ang muna gusto na itong makabot sa wili. So if we want to have our foundation in Christ, then we must live with Christ by waiting for His glorious hope. Second thing, na sometimes nagawalat kita sa glorious hope, na we will be like Him someday. It is our responsibility that we must maintain a closer walk with God. In James chapter 4, verse 8, according to James chapter 4, verse 8, come near to God and He will come near to you. Wash your hands, you sinners, and purify your hearts, you double-minded. So the thing here is that the key to maintain a closer walk with God is not just to follow the religious do's and don'ts, but to realize that God is a person. And when we say that God is a person, we mean that He is not just a force or a system, but someone who has infinite wisdom and power and love, someone who cares for us and interacts with us. If we are to live in Christ, we should also observe harmonious relationship in the church. Churches of Christ today, ang problema again is that although ang evangelism in Church of Christ, okay man, grabe ang pag-win souls, ako may kapertahan sa church. But sometimes, there will be a backdoor in the church. Nga the number of people coming in the church, mas dako ang number nga naaagi sa backdoor sa church. And dapat ako na siya punggal. If you want to live with Christ by committing ourselves to follow Him, we must close the back door of the church. How? How are we going to close the back door of the church? Nga ang tanan nga mga halaga magsulod, hindi na magwa. Of course, we must create an atmosphere, we must create an ambience of love and a warm welcome in the church. It is our responsibility as a church. Ato kita pabatsa ang gugma ng Ginoo nga every time nga makita sa mga visitors nga ang mga tao dali sa iglesia makita ang atmosphere nga ng gugma anay kita true makita nila sa kamusta nga kamusta anay kita nga fellowship kita sa isa't isa nga istorya anay kita hindi nga after worship ulit na yon di ba so kumaanan kita sa amo nga mga butang nga after worship we have to fellowship, we have to entertain our visitors. Siyempre, maka-attract kita sa mga bisita. And the back door of the church remains closed. Second thing, aside from creating a warm environment in the church, dapat natin i-equip ang atong mga membro. Dapat natin i-build ang atong mga kurandari sa church. How? That's why may arat kita mga discipleship. May arat kita sa mga activities na mag-help sa atong to prepare ourselves na sa time na from the days na wala kita din sa church, pwede kita to share the gospel. So it is our responsibility, especially leaders, to equip sa mga membro, to equip sa mga bago o magsunod, to close the back door of the church. But sometimes, they should pray, ang mga leaders, hindi man nila makaya kung sila lang. So the church, dapat maging isa kita, we should be united in creating this warm environment, warm atmosphere, building our members, our brothers, equipping them that they will be ready in sharing the gospel outside. Third, we must understand our differences. When I say about differences, it means to say that we have different skills, we have different talents, and of course we have different weaknesses. And sometimes, talents, skills, but most of the time, meaning weaknesses, amo ni siya permit na scriptures. So, let us try to find out kung paano nato dapat tinguhaan na ini aton ng mga differences. We will use our differences to create harmony. Ini aton ng mga differences dapat amo ni aton gamiton to create harmony sa church. Because if we have this harmonious relationship in the church, if we have this harmonious environment in the church, then ang pag-share sa kaskalya kapos na lang. So, we already laid our foundation to Jesus Christ. We live in Jesus Christ by obeying His command, by using the church as our preparation. Then the last thing that we must do, na hindi kinatong kalimtan, we must do the great commission of Jesus Christ. And this is the ultimate purpose na gusto niya tutulog sa atin. Pilan ka mga Christians na nakasaulog or nagpapamilyar na sa inyong Great Commission. In Matthew chapter 28, verse 19-20, although sa inyo balibalik yan eh, pero ang kulong sa Ginoo hindi siya balibalik. Ang kulong sa Ginoo nag-remind sa atin, and every time na babasahan ito, may nag-hakay sa atin sa different revelation. It's right to read, therefore go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always to the very end of the age. So there are two things that we must do by doing the Great Commission. First, we must win souls. And we must win souls. After winning souls, ano yung muna ton? Ha? At is yung grace of our God. Ay, sa taong muna na ang pagdaog na ito sa kalalila kay Gospel na. So, ang gusto sa Ginoo is that we must make disciples. How are we going to make disciples? By teaching them to obey all of Jesus' teachings and commandments. So, ang muna ang gusto sa Ginoo na i-equip natin sila, tutuluan natin sila. So, Jesus Christ is not just commanded sa mga pastors, sa mga elders. He commanded the church to do the Great Commission. Ang church sila niya ang itundok because the apostles, sila naman ang nag-represent sa church during the times sa niya ang itabalik yung Great Commission. So, we have, sa Church of Christ, may harap kita sa natawag na local autonomy. Nasa tiin ang every church, may harap sila sa strategies on how they are going to win souls and make disciples. And therefore, sa daw pa, may harap ng kita sing mga strategies and church philosophies kung paano na ito mapag-unpagit ang iglesia sa Ginoo. May harap kita dala philosophy, kaya dapat amo na siya natin i-familiarize. We must be a purpose-driven church. And the church nga ginaambal natin ang church ni Christ, amo na natin dapat i-familiarize ang iyong purpose. So, ano na ang purpose now? To share the gospel in the city of Bacolod, di ba? So, and ang vision natin, we will be having 250 members in 2016. Although, aton kita baptize members dari ara na kalapit na kita sa 200. Pero, siyempre, although kita nagkalinakat sila, pero ang nagasimba, ara na kita dyan sa mga 40 to 60s na aton nga average. So, sa times ng workers meeting namon, we have decided to have this goal of 2014 that we will be having our goal of 50 souls of 2014. Kaya? Amen kayo? Kaya? Ano kayo tayo? Amen? So, kaya? So, means to say, if we will be have a goal of 50 souls of 2014, then every month ha, dapat niya harap kita 4 to 5 souls every month. So, 50 no? Nakuinan isa kasi si Brother Art, Brasa, nagpapapais na. Trapa ka na ito ng inoote. Although wala sa day. So, 49 na lang. So, every month, ang goal natin is 4 to 5 souls. that we will be reaching them. I will close this message sa isang story na kapihan ko rin sa yak dito sa Dumaguete. Mayroon isang mayroon kasing magbarkada na si Joss at si Sam. So si si Joss Christian, si Joss, si Sam yung unbelievers. Pero best friends sila, upot sila mag-basketball, upot sila magkawasagwa, classmates sila, every day of their lives, the nights may permit. Pero tingin sila yung close. So, ini si Joss, na Christian, although nakabati naman siya na it is very important to share the gospel, especially sa, makonsider niya kasi sa amuang iya na Galilee, kay medyo lapit-lapit sa iya, isitan siya niya po sa pag-share sa gospel. Namuyak siya sa pag-share sa gospel or nakulbaan siya na basit hindi ni Lisak malawat ang gospel. Sa tayo ng mag-istoryahanay sila, si Sakman, although si Sak open-minded din siya ang tao, gusto ni Sak ng tanay na makabalong sa Bible, wala ako, pero sa iya na self, ginawalaga lang si Diyos magkabal. Sa tayo ng kanyang mag-istorya si Sak about sa mga verses, gina-change ni Diyos ang topic. Gina-change ni Diyos. May opportunity na tayo nga share si Diyos pala sa gospel ni Jesus Christ. Gina-change tayo ng topic. Kung makaabot sila dala na mag-point about sa gospel, about sa word of God. So, wala gin ni Diyos na share sa gospel ni Jesus Christ. Although, love gin niya katama, pero wala gin naabot sa tayo gin share niya si Jesus. Sa isa sa pagkat daw, si Sam nag-drive sa motor. Tapos, sa pag-drive niya ang motor, gabi na to, na-loss sa brake, na-disgrace siya si Sam. Patay din siya. Pagkapatay ni Sam, bilang months ang nag-agi, may nag-abot niya letter sa kay Josh. Sinig dito sa letter, Josh, tayo niya minsan friendship, hindi mo binatag. Na-bless mo sa friendship nato. Pero nga, wala akong higit-higit ng balal about sa gospel. Nga, damo na tayo sometimes na tani, ihambal mo sa ako ang tulong sa Ginoo, na makaangkon mo sa ginagawa ng kalawasan. Nga, wala ko lang ihambal sa ako. Ari ko subong sa impirno. Nagkaralain, puti-puti, kinitingit-ti. Nga, sa muna, tani, kung ayaw mo higit ng balal. Nga, sinamuyak ka maghambal sa ako. Kalong ikutahin sa imo nga information about si gospel. So, ano bang letter ni Sap? Kahit pwede kaya masubok kong autod. In like manner, may arap kita sa mga minahal sa kinabuhin ang ato mga friends, ang mga close na ato, na wala ka nakabalo sa pulong sa Ginoo. So, hindi natin dapat tag-uo